So the other day we saw one of the first pieces Lino made here was a white dinosaur, and it looked great. So he's doing another one. These are spectacular pieces. Does everybody know the dinosaur series? They've got tall necks that spin around. So this is a good one to watch. Not that they all aren't, but this will be great. So now that Lino's started, it'd be great if the folks standing up here in front could find a seat. Thanks. So now that things are well underway, how about we introduce the team one more time? Lino Tagliapietra, his crew, Dave Walters, Darren Dennison, and Jen Alec. How about a big round of applause for everybody? Of course, everybody appreciates that they take time to come out for the GAS conference and share what they do. It's really an honor to watch this team work together with Lino and create beautiful pieces. Again, this is going to be a piece called Dinosaur. These are tall pieces with thin looping necks. And the other day, Lino made a white one. It's beautiful, so he's making another one with various shades of white and various patterns. They picked up some filigrana cane here, and they'll, of course, be making another Marini cup to drop that down into. We asked the other day how long the team's been together, and the rookie is Darren. He's only been working with them since 2001. That was Jen. Darren's been working with Lino for about 11 years, so maybe he started a little bit later. And Dave's been working with Lino since 1994. So it explains a lot how well they work together. They've been working together for years. Not to mention they're all supremely talented to begin with. The Corning team, George Kennard is our lead gaffer. G. Bryan's here, Chris Rochelle, Brianna Barron's helping out. Jeff Mack, we have Nicholas and Oscar helping out on doors. When Lino comes to town, we want to make sure we got plenty of folks around. And you can see setting this up, everybody was busy. So it's always great to have plenty of hands in the hot shop. It's not unusual for a team like this to have 10, 12 people or more. It always comes in handy. That was a close one. It's a good thing you only had one cup of coffee this morning, I think. All right, so just checking in once again. What Lino and the crew is working on, this piece will be a dinosaur. They made a white dinosaur the other day, and it looked fabulous, so they're doing another one. And then a lot of people have been asking and always ask about the objects that Lino has created here. How can you see them? I did ask Lino, and he said after this piece, we can bring out the pieces that were made 2 days ago. So the ones that were made yesterday are still in the oven, and they won't get out until tomorrow morning. But 2 days ago, he made two Saturno pieces, and he made a couple other things. So we have four pieces that we'll bring out and set in front of the stage here after this piece. But we'll only leave them out for a while. When we get started again, we're going to take them back. The other thing you can always do is follow Lino on Instagram, on Facebook, and Twitter. And he said that's probably the best way to check out what he's been up to. A lot of the pieces that Lino makes, it's not like he'll make them here at Corning and then send them to Heller Gallery and they'll go up. A lot of things, you know, go back to Seattle. Well, everything will go back to Seattle. They'll work on it, do some cold working, they collect objects for a while until they get a show that has a nice cohesion. So it's not always a direct route from the hot shop into a gallery, and sometimes it takes a little while. So again, the best thing to do is to just keep an eye on him on social media. So if anybody's just come in, welcome to Corning. We're glad everybody's here. It's going to be a fantastic Glass Art Society conference, and this is the best way to kick it off that we could imagine, to have Lino, Dave, Darren, and Jen here making a beautiful body of work. He's been making four or five pieces a day. They typically work until about 12:30 or 1, take a lunch break, and then we're back for an afternoon session from 2 to 3 or so. So a longer morning, shorter afternoon. Anybody have any questions so far? From the peanut gallery. Everybody have a good view? Good. I like that, you know, even though we have a nice big shop here, those monitors really help out. All the glass blowers usually wind up here, and I keep promising you guys that we're going to get a monitor for you, too. It's on the books. We're working towards it. Don't have it up yet, but we will soon. Because watching what's happening on the monitors here is a great way to see the detail of what Lino's doing. Anybody want to come down and spot Dave? Not you, Skitch. Where'd you go? I know Skitch should be the first one up here. There you are. It's like, I got it. So the Dremel tool action a little bit ago was to get rid of a, there was a little bit of a haze on it from the graphite paddle. It looks like most of it came off pretty well. I took the survey a few days ago, but the people up there, how many like the smell of cork? All right. How many cork smell haters? Yeah. That's pretty much normal. Most glass makers like it, I think. I don't know if you can see it. I think probably on the monitors you can see it once in a while, but the straight filigrana underneath the Marini really adds something. It looks great. Let's not lose George. All right, there we go, safe and sound.